five ages. Your chronological age, where you can't really change that very much, but you can and make the quality of it better if you are willing. Mm. And then you have your biological age, when you go to the doctor and he does all the blood work and finds out if you have any diseases or illnesses. So the fewer diseases or illnesses you have, the better your biological age. Mm. And then we have the psychological age, the cognitive, how we think, how we function, and the lack of depression, all those kinds of things that deal with the mind. So the better you are, the healthier you are, the better your long-term, short-term memory, the better your psychological age. And then we have the functional age. How well do you do the tasks in a day? Can you lift your grandchild? Can you reach in the cabinet for the soup that's on the top shelf? Can you walk? Can you do all the things? Can you take care of your house? Can you do your housework? Mm-hmm. All of those things that we need functionally, again, how well you do it is how good your functional age is. And then finally, your social age. Mm. Do you have friends? Are you depressed? Do you go out? Are you reclusive? Do you try to interact with people? And do you know what, Angela? All of these ages can improve through movement. If people move and work out, you don't have to work out in the traditional way, but move, all these ages improve. Yeah, that's research.
And I think that that's such a, what I loved about that, it gives the power back to the person in that you can change all these different ages. Don't focus on chronological age, focus on all these ages that you can actually change and make younger. And I just think it's so, such an important message for people to understand. So thank you so much for sharing that. And